My name is Rashi and I am an entrepreneur. First of all, I am honored to be here at this platform. Thank you, FIIB, for giving me this fortunate chance where I can share my short story and experience. And I hope this turns out to be at least a little inspirational for you all. Also, I'm a little sentimental right now because this is quite personal and is a very crucial phase of my life. I've never shared this with anyone before. So my story of flying against the winds is a bunch of incidents that made me who I am today. Well, I'm not a great personality, a celebrity, or a superstar. Neither am I a person who has done great things in life. But I'm a girl who was courageous enough to overcome bullying. I believe we all were at least once bullied or were a part of a bullying gang. I was bullied a lot of times, and it started from 2010. My family faced a lot of emotional trauma and complexities as my parents got separated when I was only 12 years old. So I was immediately transferred to a school where my mother was a teacher. And all of a sudden, completely new environment, new people, and a totally different system. Most importantly, an English-speaking environment. I could hardly speak in English back then, as I had come from a central school where, unlike private schools, was no such environment. While I was trying to adapt to the changes, some people started treating me badly. They were my classmates, some of my teachers, some of my neighbors, and they started making fun of my physique. I was very skinny, so they made fun of my looks, my dressing sense, and maybe because I belonged to a middle-class family. The other day, I went to some of my classmates and said, "Let's have lunch together." And they said, "No, we don't want this girl to be with us. Gawar hai ye. Isse English nahi aati." And one of them said, "Sarkari school se aayi hai, hamare standard ki nahi hai." And they hit me aside and left me there itself. Now, a 12 years child stood there with teary eyes and could not say a word. There was already so much going in my mind. And I did not go to school the next day. I was afraid. I was scared. And that was just the beginning. It all continued for years. I shifted to Mount Abu after some times, and there were different people, but same issues. Some or the other person would come to me every day and ask me about my family, my father's photograph, even after knowing the truth. They deliberately tried to hurt me. Now, this included my neighbors, some of my classmates, some of my teachers. So I used to cry myself to sleep at nights. Every day I would prepare myself for the next day, and every day somebody would come and say something to me, and they'd make me feel that being a single parent child is a misfortune. And all of them even went down to their limits, that they started talking about my character. They tried to defame me, demean me, and this is what we call bullying. Bullying is a poison. Some people who think they are superior try to suppress the ones who they think are inferior. Some try to exercise their power through mental and physical harassment, and that it happens irrespective of the age. Now, this can destroy someone, not just mentally, but emotionally as well. You start doubting yourself. Your confidence level comes down to zero. And this was what happening with me back then. So when you do not fit in a certain standards of the society, you are treated differently. And so did I. You know, we think that child bullying is something that can be taken lightly. But it is not. हम सोचते हैं कि ये तो बच्चों में मजाक चलता रहता है, इतना तो सबके साथ होता है. In fact, that early age is a time when human brain develops. It learns, and the child is growing, so he needs attention and care. Now, because of all these things, a lot of children are found depressed at an early age. Some of them commit suicides. A lot of children are bullied for their physique, complexion, body shaming, dressing sense, financial status, and whatnot. Some could not say about it, and some do. Days passed by, and this kept happening with me. Now, most important thing here is, then what did I do? You know, I had a very good bonding with my mother. We share so many things together. So I went to her and asked her, "How do you not get affected by all of this around?" And she replied, "I have two children, bacha, who are my world. And I'm really working hard for them. So I don't have to bother about what people say." एंड आई सेड फिर मुझे क्यों लोग ऐसे कहते हैं, क्यों मुझे ऐसे ट्रीट करते हैं, आई फील हर्ट. एंड शी सेड बिकॉज यू लेट देम डू इट, यू डोंट एक्सेप्ट योर सेल्फ. ट्रस्ट मी, आफ्टर सम ईयर्स इट वोंट इवन मैटर हाउ योर हेयर लुक्ड, हाउ आर यू ड्रेस्ड, वॉट वर यू वेयरिंग, बट ऑल वॉट मैटर्स इज हाउ यू टेक केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ एंड वॉट यू लर्न अलॉन्ग द वे. Your focus should be on yourself and not people, Rashi. And that is something that had a long-lasting impact on my mind. You know, I've seen my mother fighting with all the adversities, and she raised two children alone. So I thought, if she can do it, I can also do it. And that's it. My mother became my biggest inspiration. I started mulling over it and decided to do something about it. Now, we always have two choices. It's just that one needs to identify it. I could either let things happen the way they were, or I could do something about it. I chose the latter one. I decided to beat my biggest fear, and that was public speaking. I was scared of speaking in front of public a lot. So I was in 10th grade, and each student was asked to speak for at least 5 minutes. I went there without looking here and there and started speaking. And I spoke for more than 5 minutes in English. टूटी फूटी इंग्लिश, गलत इंग्लिश बोली, लेकिन बोली, रुकी नहीं. एंड दैट वॉज द फर्स्ट स्टेप आई टुक टू स्टार्ट वर्किंग ऑन माई सेल्फ. दैट डे आई फेल्ट सो गुड अबाउट माई सेल्फ दैट एटलीस्ट आई ट्राइड. एंड ग्रेजुअली थिंग्स इम्प्रूव्ड. आई स्टार्टेड टेकिंग इनिशिएटिव्स इन माई क्लास. इन माई ट्वेल्थ ग्रेड आई पार्टिसिपेटेड इन स्कूल डिबेट कॉम्पिटिशन फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, बट आई लॉस्ट इट. आई कंप्लीटली वेंट ब्लैंक ऑन द स्टेज इन फ्रंट ऑफ ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स. But I was happy that I chose to participate, that I tried at least. And again, I did not stop. I worked hard with all the determination and went and participated in inter-school debate competition and got the runner-up trophy for my school. I didn't look back after that. That small courageous step gave me so much confidence to try every time, at least to give my best in whatever I do. So I started appreciating myself gradually for who I am and what I have. Now, this reality got sunk into me at a very early age that in spite of thinking about all of these adversities, I can cherish and enjoy the journey. And when you are so engrossed in this journey, believe you me, people, you hardly give attention to what some people say or believe. Then I was appreciated as a best speaker, best presenter, and led teams. Also, I successfully headed events. All of this would happen because I was confident enough. Now I don't get bullied. I don't get affected by what some people think of me. So what changed? People? No, I changed. Changed for a good. And I realized that I should be important to myself. And it's not selfish, it's important. This was my courageous story that made me a better version of myself. You know, we all face problems and go through tough times in life, but we need to figure out something about it. All it takes is that one step forward for self, and eventually things do fall into place. It's nobody's responsibility to come for you and act like a superhero. Nobody's gonna do that for you. So regardless of all the hardships, struggles, and complexities in life, I love the person I am becoming right now. And this did not happen overnight. I had to work really hard for it. Had to have patience to accept failures a lot of times. All the people out there, I just want to say one thing to you, that life will keep surprising you with a lot of challenges. So fear nothing, fear nobody, and have faith in yourself. Try and take that one step forward like I did. We are all given opportunities in abundance. We just need to identify it. Sit for a while for yourself today and think about everything you've never mulled over. Keep learning. Importantly, keep changing. Because if you're not changing, you're not growing. And if you're not growing, you're not really living. Good luck.